Right, Winterly Pool. And Geisenheiser.
Right, I've knocked Crompton's on the head.
So I'm fishing. Winterly Pool. This is my swim. First rod is down to my left, where I've seen some bubbles. It's quite a bad fish on that spot before as well. Middle rod is sort of over there, seen bubbles again. There's bubbles all over this swim. And the other one is sort of down here, sort of halfway across. But there's been bubbles up and down this margin. In front of me, well, just in front of me in general. So I'm expecting. I'm hoping to get a take very soon. I hope so. It's been fizzing up. In fact, there's more over to me right again. Right, let's turn it round. Yo, right, back on Winterly Pool. I'm gonna crack on my Winterly Pool. I think again, like I did last year. I had some decent fish out last year. Crompton's knocking on the head. I'm not going to rejoin in April, start of April. I'm not going to bother. I think they're asking for like photo, passport photos and all that stuff, sort of stuff now. So do this and you're in front of the committee. Do that and you'd be seen by the. I understand about dipping nets and that, do you know what I mean? I understand that. But I dipped my net when I went on there anyway. Right, yeah. Yeah, plenty of fizzing. Loads of activity around this side. Come to the right side. Kid over the other side. I spoke to Mark the bailiff yesterday. He said he went on last night and he said they've been coming out over the weekend. Pretty much each peg's done a fish at least. Where he is opposite me, that did four yesterday. So he moved off the specimen lake onto here last night. Well, yesterday tea time, I think I phoned Mark because he's just moved on. But he said no one else was on. So I was like, rubbing my hands together. Oh, I thought he'd beat them. Yeah, I've had a couple of liners already. The quality of fishing here, every fish I've had has been undamaged. It's been pretty much immaculate, and there's some decent fish as well. There's a big koi, orange one called Tango, £22. I was told that was the biggest, but I've heard there's one slightly bigger, like a dark mirror. I think it's 23-ish. There's a £21 white ghoster, but you know, when they're cruising around under the surface, you can see it a mile away. That comes out on floaters easily, I'm told, but not my bag floater fishing. I've got the gear in that, you know, I've got the floats and all that, but if I have to, I will do. But yeah, not been on the bank for a while, so not been any video, so hopefully now, I'm going to try and get out at least, minimum, every fortnight, every other week. I've been working a lot. Trying to get back into the old gym, and just had a lot of my toes really. I've been out for my birthday, 18th February. Looking at 5 weeks, I reckon. It feels like forever. But yeah, right, back on Winterly Pool. Buzzing, fishing. It's raining, good. Air pressure was a little bit over 1,000 before. I don't know how to read into that too much or not, but. Slight breeze, not a lot though, but we're here doing it. Team Winterly Pool, yes,
come on!
There's the old rods in the cradle. Let's use three rods on here, Mark, which is good. What happened before, I didn't want to touch my rods, but I've changed one of them. Because, right, this morning, I found a spot tight to that island, but it's a bit hard because there's no leaves. It's a bit hard to see the thick branches. So I managed to find it, but it took me about 15 casts. So I put it out and I thought, I'm not happy with that. So anyway, I had the middle rod where I had it, but right in the middle there between the two islands, it's shallower, but there's usually lily pads all along there. All here and all in the middle, but there was absolutely loads, and I mean serious fizzing. So I panned a single pop up
right, well, just in the middle, put it past the fizzing, and then wound it back, and it's sort of in the middle. It's where them geese are now, it's under that goose-ish, a bit further towards me. Yeah, but it's been it's just bubbles everywhere. I don't know if you can see them. Can't really see them on the camera. I can't zoom in anymore either. Yeah, but I remain confident because the rods are in, and I'm confident I'm in the right area, definitely. I just wish those geese.
Right, that fizzing, I cast to the middle between the two islands, that fizzing's long gone. It's levering it down. Yeah, it's pretty wet. So what I've done, I've brought the rod in. It's fizzing now actually, just on the edge of them snags, sort of the edge of the island, on the corner of it. So what I've done, I've took my single pop-up off, and I've got ball bat rig, one of them new long shank fang twisters, and I've got a trimmed down bottom bait with a trimmed down 12mm pop up that sinks slowly. That I balanced it. I've got some boily crumb and a little PVA nugget, so that'll just off the bottom like that, and when the strands of a PVA melt, that'll just settle down like that. That's a semi stiff uplink, that, so it's balanced, it should kick away. Hook will sit flat and that'll sit above it, hopefully with some of that crumb like around it. Oh, liner, another liner, boom. Yeah, so when the rain stops in about, well, say when it stops, hopefully when it calms down a bit, that's going out. Ah, bad one. Just moved my rod onto the fizzers, fizzing again in the middle. Oh, it's lively. Give me a good fight. I put a rod on it, a little PVA bag. It kept fizzing back and forth to the middle. It was going, then coming, and fizzing again, then not. So I put a rod on it, and about literally 2 minutes later, sat down to eat a pot noodle, and this charged off. Oh yes. Guess it's got to be 13-14 pound or so. I'm gonna wait in a minute just to see, out of interest. It's not a. Okay, it's okay. Oh, lovely. Good account, really good account of itself. Yeah, buzzing. First session back on Winterley Pool. Not a bad choice, eh? Right, yeah, right, I'll weigh her, him, her, and then we'll put it back. Yes, finally got a fish for you. Buzzing, quality, like, live in session, or whatever you want to call it. Yes, come on. Say see ya. Well, put all three rods out to where the fizzing was, where it's on and off. Now we're right and rod's gone. Been in 5 or 6 minutes and it's gone. A bit smaller. Well, I think it's got a slight set of shoulders on him. Nice though, a few nice scales and that. Stick a bit of carp care on his mouth. But yeah, look at that door, very angry. Two. Yes, come on now, we're rocking now. I bet I was fishing a rod length off these with nothing, a rod length shorter, and I've not had anything at all. And I'll put put all three rods longer now, and I've had two fish. So it just shows you the difference, doesn't it? Right, yeah, let's stick him back. Quality, yes, two. Got the Nash one. Where is it? I've not switched the camera off. Don't matter, does it? Hope it don't sting, mate. Ooh. There you go. How's that?
There we go. There you go. Good as new! Right,
got two fish now. Still fizzing up in that middle bit between the islands. Made myself a brew. I deserve one for my effort. New cup. Well, I got two. I bought that. What did I buy? That new Camelite brew kit bag. There's the bag. Obviously, my brewing stuff's out in it, kettle and all that. But you get two of them. Little teaspoon. Smart. Get two of them cups. Fox ones. That carp scales on them. Two of them. Best bit. It's quality. I can't believe it took so long for someone to bring one of these out. Right, look, little camo. What are they called? Them cover. And you've probably already seen these anyway on the videos and that. But that little milk thing, and that's cold. That it's insulated inside. Isn't it smart? That obviously that's got like a rubber seal on it, so it's like air. It's watertight, isn't it? But airtight. Yeah. About time they brought one out. Somebody. Well, in Fox. So. My rig. Right, this is the rig. It's the same rig. The only difference is, it's bright in here, isn't it? Why is it so bright? My hand looks like it's glowing up, like it's glowing. Right. I'll try and show you if you're not blinded by my hand. Right, we've got, where's the camera? Right. Dumbbell. That is a Nashmani special dumbbell. You can't buy them anymore. One of the Daves who works in the shop sold me a load he had in his freezer. But they are Manchester Special 2 Tangy Spice ones. Sideways dumbbell. Pop up sweet corn, balances it, just sinks slow. Hook, blowback tube, liner, semi-stiff, what's it called? Hook braid, semi-stiff coated braid. Little anti-tangle sleeve. I don't like the ones that are like dead long. I don't know why, it's just annoying me looking at them. So I trimmed it just enough to cover the quick chain swivel. But the only thing, that's the actual rig what had my first fish. The second rig is back out again. What had the second fish. But the only difference is the pop-up corn is orange on the other one. I've done quite well on orange on here, actually. When I had some Royal Marine 4 orange pop-ups, Baitworks ones. They stink, but they're good. My PB came on them, actually. Well, it's a snowman tip with an orange one. But yeah. Yeah. It's only 12:30, I think, ish. I'll be here till 8. It's 7:30, me. So hopefully we can eke one more out. But they're still fizzing there, still. So, come on, carp and I go. I'm just glad I am blanked, finally. Evidence that I've caught a fish. Hey, won't believe this. Hang on. Oh, look at that orange one. Got a koi. Wait a minute. Boom! Double take for the pieman I got. Had to play one between my knees and put the net back together. That orange koi is a beast. The other one's only small, but double take. How's that for location? Right, I better sort it out, Anna. I'll see you in a minute. Boom. Oh God, you won't believe this. Well, you've seen, double take. This is the first one, it's the bigger one of the two. Oh, it's done me in that, I've just weighed it, £17 exactly. £17 orange koi, it's absolutely stunning. Got a net down there, it's got the other one in it, which is a small, I think it's a mirror. That'd be a common. Anyway, this is the pick of the bunch. This is why I come to Wintley Pool, this is why I've come back, fish like this. Look at that. Hang on. Look at that. Look at that, it's just... That's stunning, that, innit? Let's be honest. Look at that. There's more of these, innit? Oh, yeah. Absolutely buzzing. £17 exactly. Blowback rig. Again. But, bottom bait tip with a 12mm. Sort of pastel pink pop up, just trim down so it sinks over. Yeah, on that fizzy spot again. Yes, right, it's getting back. It's been out though. I've kept him wet, I've looked after him, but that's just getting back now. I'll show you the other one. This one's been recovering in the water. There we go. Times like this, all the blanks just fade away, they just go. You just out your brain then.
And glasses like
Like Egon. Egon had Ghostbusters with the glasses on his bloody nose. Very angry. It could. Right, yeah. Lovely. Nice and dark though. Yeah, so that's the second of a double take. I had that orange cord, 17 pounder, in here, in the cradle, waiting, and then the other rod went, the right hand rod. Interestingly, the left hand rod, the one with the pop up, hasn't gone again. So I'm going to swap that. I was actually testing a snowman. I'm walking back from testing a balanced snowman. I was going to swap the pop up for it because the pop up hasn't gone. And that just confirms it for me. They obviously want it on the bottom, don't they? So I'll adapt, I'll get rid of the pop up and put up, snowman on. Right, yeah, let's get this one back as well.
See your son, go and tell your mum where the bait is.
Right, so, still fishing out towards, in between the two islands. Took the pop up off my left one, and rather than put it on the same as the other two, like snowmen, bottom baits, I put a zig on it. I know where I'm fishing, it's dead lily pads on the bottom. Well, that's where the pads usually are. I'm not always getting a drop, but what I've been doing, I've been pulling, feeling the lead down, pulling it, not even about half a yard maybe. If it's smooth and it moves normal, if it's okay, I'll just leave it then. That's where I've been getting the bites. If I feel it's not right, or it's pulling a bit, it's snagged on something, I'll just bring it in and do it again. I know multiple casting, I know you'll spook the fish, but they keep coming back. So some days, they'll probably do the off, they'll do one, and I won't see them again. Today, it doesn't seem to have bothered them, luckily for me. So yeah, I put a zig on. Wherever the lead lands, that's it. Well, it's about 1.5 foot. So, yellow foam, black zig liner. So I've gone the opposite. So having a pop up, I've gone a lot further up now. They must be cruising in, dropping down. But at some point, they must be off the bottom because the fizzing's not constant. Or you know. So I'm hoping that little yellow zig bit of foam with the zig liner. If they drift in again, touch wood. That might pick one up as well, and we'll get one on a zig, but I'll keep you updated. Fingers crossed. Struck again. Oh, it's all right, this one. 14.5 pound. Right. Oh, lively though. It didn't really put up well. It fought a bit at first, but then it sort of came in. It didn't do much fighting. Didn't do much fighting close in, so it's been pretty lively. It took me a few minutes to sort get it to calm down so I can take the hook out of its mouth. Yeah, 14.5. Lovely mirror. Yeah, quality. Absolutely nailed. Bottom lip, right in the middle. I couldn't have put it there. I couldn't have put the hook anywhere better myself. Them new Gardner rigger curve hooks are ridiculously curved. Like the eyes angled in like 90 degrees, but no shrink tube or anything. Brilliant. Yeah, so yeah, 14.5 pound. Boom. Quality. Yes, number 5 on a roll today. That's the most I've ever had here. All last year, the most I've had was 4 in a day. Oh, right. Let's get him back. Definitely a him. Very angry. Oh, mind you, it's probably a woman. It's probably a female. Very angry. Disobedient as well. Right, coming to the end now. Barrel sort of started. Been fizzing up again. I've seen a fish. Hang on. Between the islands. One's shown over my right hand rod. One's shown over my left hand rod. No, middle rod, sorry, middle rod. But yeah. Rods are still in. They're staying until last then. I'm going to stay into that first little bit of darkness, half an hour. Obviously everything else is down and that. Trying to dry the old sling out over there. But yeah. Can't grumble, can I? 5. I would have took one before I come. So yeah, buzzing. Hopefully. Might be 6. If it is, well, you'll see, won't you? But yeah. Nearly the end of the session, but I can't moan. Yes. Right, that's it, car's loaded. Just started raining as well, I just got in the car. It's been my day today, hasn't it? Yeah, 5 fish. It was fizzing up. Ugh, there was 2 shoals near over to me rods. I was like, oh, do I stay? And I thought, you know what? Let's get home. Let's just get home. I need a bath. My back's doing me in. And I've had 5 fish. I can't really be moaning if I don't get a 6th, you know what I mean? Oh, I'm knackered now. I'm getting too old for this pushing a barrel lark. Yeah, so, success finally. All that, say it was on a different lake, Crompton's won it, but all the effort, even back end of last year, I did a 48 and a 72, and it had nothing. I lost one on the 72 on the third morning. I lost a fish. I'd waited like 50 hours for it or something. I was absolutely gutted. I struggled back end of last year though. My last fish from there was September the summit, 17 pound common. Day session. I've never caught doing a night on Winnerley Pool, ever. Always days, so I don't know if it's something in it. I think I fish the same way. But what matters, success today, buzzing. So I'll enjoy this, having a good day today. Right, sweet. And well, back here next week. So tune in for the next episode. Quality, right? Pymanigar out. Not Pymanigar. No, let me clear something up. Pymanigar, I said it before actually, when I had 2 fish in the net. That was my nickname, it's a long story that, from years ago. Changed it to Carp and Igo. So if I slip up and say Pime and Igo, it's the same person. Right, Carp and Igo out. Boom!